pretty crazy.
Yeah.
Oh, he's got some cool stuff. That's like the Yoshi Lucas thing where if they dip down during the double jump, you can wave land off, and it looks pretty cool.
Kyle.
Huh. Yeah, camera's frozen.
Oh,
Chris
it is.
Chris is still eating his thing there.
Which? I don't know which one is which.
Just follow the cord. Follow the cord. That's probably because Hindog was playing with it.
I might have kicked it, too.
Maybe. You might have kicked it?
Because he was playing with the other one.
Oh. Oh, yeah, you're right. Just give us 1 second, guys. We're trying to figure out this camera issue.
Oh, it got unplugged. That would be why it's frozen.
That would do it.
All right, so we might need to... You might need to refresh it.
Refresh?
Properties, yeah.
Yeah. It's
why does it think it's game capture HD?
I don't know, actually.
Interesting.
Let's see.
There we go. Now we're good.
Hooray!
I'm gonna move it. All right. Yeah, play with it. But
yeah,
we can start going with the match.
Yeah, go for it.
That was interesting. Why is he moving it?
No, it's good. No. I like what he just did.
Okay.
Okay, we're good.
Fair enough.
All right. So now we're finally ready to go early Aki game one.
Sorry about that, guys.
Yeah, we got technical issues. You know.
Yeah, right.
Someone messing with webcams.
Nothing major.
Yeah, about Aki.
Aki.
Yeah, let's talk about him. So he's from Northern Illinois, I think?
Yeah, he's one of the Gamers HQ regulars.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Okay.
From what I hear, at least, because last time he was here, someone was like, hey, I just lost to that Gamers HQ guy. And I had to play him, and I actually lost to him, too, back in 3.0.
Yeah.
All
I know is I heard that he's like a kind of technicalness.
Yeah.
Maybe not quite as much as Octorok, but
yeah, I'm not really sure. They definitely have different styles.
Okay.
From what I've played against both of them.
Right.
So, yeah, Octorok. I mean, this is 3.0, so a lot of them, you know, PK Fire was a big approach option.
Right.
So it's kind of cool to see how Nessus are approaching the character now that it's not as easily.
What?
Oh my God! He almost got that.
Yeah, Ness almost went through him. He might have actually gone one too much. Oh, my God.
Okay, that's cool.
So
I like that.
Aki is just dunking on him. He's like, dude, sit down.
See, that's what he does. He really likes using platforms for PK Fire.
Okay.
Because he likes that angle.
So it's kind of like a Sheik kind of.
Sheik Needle, yeah. Sheik Needle, but with, you know.
That's very Sheik-like. That's kind of cool.
Burny projectile thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. And I think a lot of these combos are working because Fast Faller and Combo and Falcon.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. Early, not happy with that one.
Nope. That's not one you want to give away like that.
No. Really hard to come back from this kind of a lead.
Falcon can do it. I don't know.
Of course, yeah. It can be a little difficult to edgeguard Ness, though.
True.
Or Falcon. Just the disjointed hitbox. It's kind of akin to Firefox, because you really can't go out there so much with Falcon versus the charge-up.
That's true.
So it's kind of like edgeguarding a better Firefox.
No, there's nothing better than Firefox, dude.
There's nothing better than Firefox?
It's not Firefox, therefore it's not better.
Okay, yeah, so
he's taking the same approach for his edgeguards.
Yeah, and even then, it's like the
disjoints are like that weird.
And they're more powerful, too. Oh, wow.
He still has jump. Okay. I thought he lost his jump for some reason.
Down throw. Oh, my gosh. You need to do the full hop to get the knee.
That was just good DI mix-up. From Aki's part.
Definitely. And you know, with how much percent he has, like, yeah, he's in the one-hit range.
That was pretty rough.
Yeah.
I think we're going to see him. I don't know if he's going to want to go Bowser. I don't know if that's what he's thinking.
So in 3.0, I'm not sure how much this has changed, but Ness destroyed fat characters.
Oh,
he was like, if you shield once, you're going to get stuck.
Yeah,
forever.
But now he doesn't have that shield.
Yeah, but
so.
It's still the same problem because they can't escape the pillar.
That's true.
So even if they get burned at all, then you're still kind of eating a lot of... You're still eating the max punch.
That's true.
Yeah. 2, 1, go! Kicked
it. Okay, so he is sticking with Falcon.
Yeah.
I was seeing him playing Mewtwo on stream earlier, so I was thinking maybe it was a chance that he was going to...
No.
He was thinking about it, but...
Aurelia says, Mewtwo is dead to me.
Oh, okay.
Mewtwo is dead.
Rip.
Yeah, Rip Arena. I just think like the unfamiliarity of the character is really what it's going to be all about. I mean, Ness is small. It's kind of hard to combo him.
Yeah, with Octorok not around, he's in at school down in Southern Illinois like a jerk. We don't have a NES around here anymore, so.
Yeah.
I don't know how much Chris was playing back when Octorok was still around. I don't know if he was as active as he is now.
I think they definitely played, and I'm pretty sure Chris did pretty well against him. But, you know, just how you approach the matchup in general and how NES are approaching is completely different.
Yeah, true.
And, you know, like you said, they're playing completely different. Aki has been getting a lot of mileage out of these downers off stage.
Oh, yeah. Just downers in general. He's getting them on stage, too.
Right, right. And that's what's ending early stocks early, is just getting predicted and spiked.
Yep. And he is tech chasing him with down throw, which is really smart.
Mm-hmm. You can also combo him with up throw as well.
Yeah, he actually was doing that a little bit last game towards the end. On Battlefield, not so much because the platform is kind of getting in the way.
Wow.
But that was a really crazy combo. Actually, he's getting a lot of mileage out of punishing missed techs and using Psy Magnet offstage.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Psy Magnet's been huge for him.
Good option on the roll. And this is looking pretty dominant.
This is another, looking like another 3-stock possibly.
Oh. Oh, he's going.
Yeah.
Wow.
He almost got the full power. Oh, nice angle from Aki.
Yeah, it seems like Aki's really solid on all of his recovery options.
You kind of have to be with a character like Ness.
Yeah, that's true. Now, let's see if Aureli can close out his stock.
Yeah, that would definitely help him. But this is not going to.
No.
Oh, he avoids the extra pressure.
Yeah.
And a mystery from Aki.
What is he doing?
Why would he do that?
I don't, is he trying right now? I'm not sure.
I think he is, but at the same time, he's not. I think he just wants...
Okay, there we go.
I think he's doing it to kind of psych himself out, maybe. Like, hey, if I land this Falcon Punch, I'm going to win.
Right.
Or, like, if I win that, it's Falcon Punch, just quit out of the game like Hells did that one time.
Oh.
That, ooh. Really smart option from Aki, but just barely misspacing the bat.
Oh! He knew that the yo-yo covers that option.
Oh, and it barely kills him off the top.
And good stuff to Aki, 2-0 Aureli.
That was crazy.
Yeah.
Good stuff to Aki. And he just shrugs it off like, what? I don't even know.
I'd consider that an upset, wouldn't you?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, considering Aki.